So did you grow up with the name Walt and with the initials Walt D and just think, I've got to be an animator when I'm getting
Well, both my dad and my grandfather were Walt D, so I inherited the name. But I started getting into animation when I was very young, and then I was like, oh, obviously Walt Disney. And here's a fun fact that we have the same birthday too, December 5th. I know. So I was like, this is destiny. I have to stay in animation.
Yeah. I love the aesthetic to this. There's that kind of fuzzy feel. I was wondering if you could tell me a little bit about the design and how you created the world in Trolls.
Yeah, you know, from the first Trolls and then pushing even further in Trolls World Tour is we wanted the world to have this kind of handmade feel, you know, where it doesn't look like all the other, you know, computer-generated movies, that it feels like it exists in real space. And I think having that tangible, fuzzy immersion allows that.
So did you work with, a different director in this one?
I had a co-director, Dave Smith.
Because I remember I interviewed you and Mike for the last one. He said that you've got to counterbalance each other because you're very happy and he's a little bit cynical. Yeah. I was just wondering about the dynamic. And well, you sort of represented Branch and Poppy in many regards. What was the dynamic like with David on this? Did it follow a kind of similar?
Very similar. You know, Dave Smith and I, and we went to college together, much like Mike and I. So we always wanted to make a movie together, and this was the one. And we are similar in many ways, but he is definitely more sarcastic like Branch, and I am the optimist like Poppy.
Yeah, because that must be so cool when you sort of go to college with someone. If you sort of could go back and tell yourself that the two of you be here making a big DreamWorks movie together, that'd be, because when you first started, was it always, when you met, was it always the intention to one day make something together? And how did it feel when you finally...
Yeah, we hoped we could work together, and we had done some TV shows together. And just this opportunity came up. He was free and I wanted to work with him again. And we would look at each other during the 3-year process of this. We couldn't believe it. Like, we can't believe we're making this. And like, our younger selves would have loved this movie. And we couldn't be more grateful.
I know Justin Timberlake obviously is a huge part of this, but he's more than just a voice artist. He's a music producer on the film. Is that right?
Yeah.
So tell me about his sort of input into this.
Yeah, he was integrated into this much earlier than Trolls 1. So we pitched the idea to him, this idea of different genres, and that really excited him to be able to collaborate with all these different musicians and really just pitch the whole story to him.
Because he's part of an amazing voice cast. How was it directing and giving instructions to the likes of Mary J. Blige? Because not many people get to tell Mary J. Blige what to do.
And neither did I. I just kind of set up the scenario. I go, here's the situation, and I'll read with them. But I really want them to bring themselves. So I give the freedom of that. And I let them have a lot of input. And like Justin and Anna, they improvise a lot of lines. And whatever Mary wanted to do, I said, okay.
And that's the best way to work. Yeah. And Sam Rockwell as well. How was he to collaborate?
Oh, Sam Rockwell was amazing. You know, he plays Hickory, you know, a country troll. But he showed up to the first voice casting session all dressed in a cowboy outfit. I was like, you don't really need to do that. You know, it's not but he is an incredible actor, man.
I just like the idea of him turning up in a cowboy outfit.
It's so funny. Yeah. He had a lasso and he was lassoing us at the craft services table to prove that he could do it.
This film is an interesting thing, because the whole point and part of this is showing off our differences and celebrating our differences. Yeah. But at the same time, I suppose what you've got to do is kind of veer into the world of stereotypes in a way, because you've kind of to really enhance that. I was wondering about that balance and kind of in ensuring that it shows off all of our differences sort of culturally to do with music without sort of veering too far into the stereotype.
Yeah, I think you're right. And it was a hard thing to do with a short running time and so many different genres. I think that's really why we had to cast it with such authentic musicians. You know, that's why we had to have Ozzy Osbourne and Mary J. Blige and George Clinton, like, to really cast it authentically allowed us to not be stereotypes, I think.
So just very finally, can we see more Trolls in the future?
I hope so. You know, we'll see that if everybody likes this one, we're ready and raring to go on the next one.
Brilliant. Well, Sam will turn up as a cowboy again.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Nice. Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching Hey You Guys.
Hey You Guys, huh?
Hey You Guys.
Is that from The Goonies?
It is indeed, yeah.
Nice.
Hey You Guys.